Hey guys, what's up, it's your boy SR7 and welcome back. Today we're going to be reviewing Future Stars Charles Du Cattelier. So as you know, EA did release a dual player pick for a Future Stars Du Cattelier. Two different options there, one looking slightly better than the other. So what I am going to do is me and my cousin, who does run his own YouTube channel, KLN Studios, we are going to take one each out of the two options in the player pick. We are going to go for one each. I will review one, he will review the other, and we will tell you which one we think is better. So I am going to take the striker Du Cattelier. My cousin is going to take the left wing Du Cattelier. And like I said, we are going to go through the cards, play with the cards, see how we feel the cards are. And then we are going to compare them at the end and see which one we think is better. And we are going to include a match where we do play each other so we can see which card comes out on top. So I've gone for the striker card. As you can see, it is a fantastic card. It looks absolutely incredible. And this version that I've gone for is a 6'4" left-footed, as he is in both versions. High medium work rates, but this one has 4-star skills and a 5-star weak foot. Then looking at, and I mean, he can actually play striker, center forward, and left wing as well. So pretty much the same positions in both. Then looking at his stats, he's got 88 pace with 90 sprint speed. He's got 91 shooting with 93 finishing and 92 positioning and shot power. He's got 90 passing with 94 vision, 91 short passing and long passing. He's got 88 dribbling with 89 ball control, 89 dribbling and 90 composure. He's got 91 heading accuracy as well as 90 physical with 92 jumping and 93 strength. Fantastic looking card, absolutely crazy. To me, this one looks like the much better card. But anyway, let's get into the gameplay, let's see how he plays, and I'll give you guys my thoughts on the card at the end of the video. So, getting into the first clip here, we do get the ball with Marquez. We played up to Du Cattelier there before rolling across to Fagioli. Onto the ball here with Osimhen, and we go for the chip shot, and luckily for us, that ball was not going to get into the back of the net. But big boy Du Cattelier gets up high, and he does put that into the back of the net with a great header. Good bit of play from him there, good bit of game reading, and he does score the goal. Here we get the ball, Du Cattelier again, nice play there, he goes across the goal. Keeper saves it, but we come right back down, play it back over the top to him. Great ball from Osimhen, and a great finish once again from Du Cattelier. We are going to celebrate here because that was a nice little header, a nice little play, and a great goal all round. Up next, we get the ball here with Osimhen again. We play it out wide to Pogba, into Jairzinho. We find Du Cattelier here with the ball, and great play there, great dribbling, and a nice ball into Jairzinho again. He finishes that with aplomb. Great play from Du Cattelier to set up that chance before coming right back down again here. Beautiful ball over the top, perfectly timed run to beat the offside trap, and we square that to Du Cattelier, who rolls the ball into the open net. Up next, we get the ball here with Osimhen again. We play it down to Du Cattelier. Nice dribbling here, we look for the ball, a beautiful pass played over the top there to Osimhen. He brings it down, and unfortunately he is not able to score, but that was just a fantastic ball from Du Cattelier. Here we go with Osimhen again on the ball. Great play here to get around the defenders. The shot does take a deflection, but it beats the keeper and finds the back of the net before going from this throw-in here, playing a nice little 1-2 around the defender, going for the, pretty much after the first touch, going for a fantastic outside foot shot there, which beats the keeper all ends up, giving him no chance whatsoever. Get the ball here with Marquez. We play it down to, I think his name is Fagioli or something like that, but anyway, back down to Du Cattelier. Du Cattelier over the top there to Osimhen, a beautiful cross, and a, once again, a fantastic bit of heading from Osimhen. Onto the ball now again with Fagioli. And we play this ball over to Du Cattelier. A fantastic scissor kick there. Very Zlatan Ibrahimovic-esque. And he puts that ball into the back of the net. Again here with Du Cattelier. Keeper comes out. And unfortunately, we lose possession of the ball. But we get it back here again. And Du Cattelier, no mistake this time, he puts that ball into the back of the net. Jairzinho on the ball here. We get it with Du Cattelier. And a beautiful bit of dribbling there to get around Van Dijk. Very, very evasive. Very good, and he makes no mistake with the finish there, tucks the ball into the back of the net. And as you can see, here we go, the big game against my cousin. Here is his team, experience his Decathlier, he did take the other version, so we are going to put them up against each other and let's see who comes out on top. So onto the ball here with Decathlier. He gets, unfortunately we lose the ball, but he wins it back here on his own pretty much, and he comes up with a beautiful bit of play. Absolutely fantastic. Skins the defenders alive, leaves them on the floor, leaving them to fetch their ankles. It was just absolutely crazy bit of play there and a fantastic finish. There we go, another good pass from Decathlier and it is cleared off the line. So as you did see, we did win that game. We did get a goal. We did get almost an assist there. My cousin's Decathlier didn't really do much. So we did come out on top. The striker version did prove to be the better card at the end of the day. It did come out on top. It did prevail over the left wing version. So we definitely made the right choice here and we definitely picked the right card. So as you can see, we do end this review with 10 games, 9 goals and 2 assists. That's 11 goal contributions from just 10 games, which is a pretty good goal return, especially for a card of the stature. So running through the card one by one, going off of pace. Honestly, he's not the fastest player, but he's definitely not slow by any means. He's got the pace, he's got the speed, and once he builds up that speed over a few meters, nobody's going to catch him. He gets to a really good top speed, he's really quick, and he's very fast in that aspect. When it comes to shooting, his shooting is outrageous, absolutely phenomenal. One of the best ball strikers in the game, he's such a good finisher. He's got the 5-star weak foot as well, so left foot or right foot, doesn't matter. He can finish it on both sides. I mean, he's just absolutely crazy good when it comes to shooting. Genuinely one of the best shots that I've used on this game. Passing, this guy is a striker with the passing of dreams. Passing of prime Xavi, prime Iniesta, prime Pirlo, Zidane, whoever you want to call it, this guy can do it all. He's up there with those players in terms of passing. His passing is just honestly cracked. It is phenomenal. He can play a pass from anywhere on the field, ping it to a teammate, and just put it on a plate for them. And they will score it 10 times out of 10 because this guy's passing is so accurate that it just lands at their feet. They can collect it in their stride and it just makes it so easy for his teammates. When it comes to dribbling, he is 6'4", so you might think that he might be a bit clunky. He might feel like a bus, but honestly, doesn't really feel that way too much at all. He's got very good close control. He's got very good movement for such a big guy, especially in tight spaces. He can move fairly quickly. He can move fairly well. He's a pretty mobile player. He can get the ball. He can dribble. He can get past the opposition. He is fast as well, so he's got that burst of speed. He's strong. He's powerful, so he can hold his own. So, you know, dribbling is actually more than sufficient, if I'm being honest with you. There's nothing to worry about there. And when it comes to physical, I mean, this guy is a man mountain. He's so big, he's so large, nobody's going to push him off the ball. He's just absolutely incredible. So all in all, what do I think of this card? Like I said, he's a fantastic card. He can do it all. He's just so good in every stat, in every category. He's just an all-rounded, well-rounded card. Just an absolutely phenomenal card. A demon, a beast, an absolute animal on this game. Like I said, pretty steep in price, though. He is coming in at around 300k, which can be kind of costly, if I'm being honest. But realistically, this is an absolutely fantastic card and he is 100% worth that price. So like I said, for me personally, the striker version is much better than the left wing version. So if I were you, I would go for this version as well, because personally, I prefer it over the other version by a long shot. So do I give him the stamp of approval? 100%, yes I do. Like I said, a fantastic player, a game changer, and he has the capability to win you games on his own. So he is 100% worth that price. Then what do I give him as a rating out of 10? He gets a 9 out of 10, which is a fantastic rating. That just pushes him into the upper echelons of my ratings and it puts him just at the base of the top tier, because honestly, that's what this guy is. He's an elite level attacker, he's an elite level striker, just an absolutely crazy card to have, a crazy card to get, and he is 100% worth it. Definitely a card that you will not regret getting and not forget putting your team, because like I said, he is a game changer and he will win you games on his own. So don't forget guys, like I said, my cousin did review the other version of this card, so if you would like to check out that review, head over to his channel KLN Studios and give his video a watch, like it, subscribe to his channel as well. I will link that video down below in the description. Okay, so anyway guys, that pretty much brings us to the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, smash that thumbs up button, leave a like on this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet done so already, and until next time guys, peace.